We're going to go ahead and get started right now with our CK12 new features webinar today, and we're going to dive right in to our simulations. We released this just 2 days ago, and we're so excited showing it to others. Now, what are simulations? These are interactive, immersive ways for students to learn. And right now we're focusing on physics. So let me dive into that. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on Get Started here. And the next screen that you should be seeing are a bunch of simulation tiles. And right now we've developed over 60 different physics simulations with certainly more to come. What I'm going to do is just click on the first one here. It's a violin simulation. In general, the simulation has three key components. The first is what I would call a narrative or a thought-provoking question or set of questions that are presented to a student. And I'll put it out there right now, there is no audio. Doesn't mean we're never going to consider doing that, but something that we've thought intentionally about is, should a teacher use this in a classroom? And they allow students to log on to CK12 in that classroom environment, and they have the ability to load the same simulation all on their own. We had a concern about the audio being all in different places, all being played at different points in time. And yes, we know you can mute it, and so those are things that we're still thinking about. One thing I'll point your eyes towards right now is on the top left of my browser, you see that it's a CK12 exploration series and that all important word beta. This is something very new. We're excited to release it. Keep that in mind that it is a beta. It's something that's ready to be used and consumed, but we're certainly going to be learning a lot about that usage over the coming weeks and months. The simulation has been playing on its own, but there's a couple of interface buttons I want to draw your attention to. The first being on the lower left. You are able to skip the narrative. So if you happen to want to replay, re-engage a particular simulation, by all means, feel free to use that skip button, and you can move ahead, so you can move through those different portions. If you wanted to pause at some point in the middle bottom piece, you can pause. If you want to skip further up to that next component, you can do that as well. And so with that, I'm going to click on the next arrow that moves us over to next component of our simulation. And that second piece is where all of that sort of science and all of the sort of the content, that pedagogy, all gets overlaid into this real world example. And we're asking about string frequency and movement and vibration. And these are all real things that we see around us, whether it's this instrument or a guitar, any stringed instrument. But now we're putting the content, the science behind it, the physics around it. And this is meant to really excite the learner, taking something that's real, that's known, and then starting to apply the concepts, the content, the learning behind it. And what you're seeing on screen, on the top left, and as well as on the top right, are different graphs that portray, as the string is vibrating, what's really happening from a science perspective here. Now, before we dive into some of the areas that we can interact with, I want to point your attention to this gear icon. And this gear icon is going to exist in any number of our over 60 simulations, and certainly more to come in the near future. So that when I click on the gear icon, I've got four different options here for me. I can certainly look at more information, which I'll do, and it just expands on, it gives me some content knowledge about what I'm seeing portrayed in this graph. I can go back, and if I want to click on zoom, it's going to essentially zoom solely into that particular graph for me to examine more closely. Or if I want to remove the graph, I can go ahead and click on hide in case the screen gets a little bit sort of too congested and I want to see some more detail. And then something that's fun and interesting is that as we start to engage and interact with the graphs or the different elements on screen, the graphs begin to redraw themselves, showing the difference, the movement, the changes. And we can see that. We can either view the last run, the current run, or we can fully disable it. By default, the runs are on. So you can see the change, each sort of change as I manipulate the different sliders and the different buttons on screen. But you can also disable that, so you just see the sort of the grid itself. Now, the next one is we have an info button, and this is found across the different pieces that are interactive. The information button is essentially telling you the behavior of that particular slider. Now, if I click to close the button and here for string tension, I might decide, well, what if string tension were set lower? You'll notice now that on the top left and the top right, those are elements that were redrawn. If I decide to set it all the way to its highest tension, we'll redraw that as well. And now you'll see that difference, that change in state. And you can go ahead and use the middle slider and say, oh, I want to hear or I want to try out the frequency of the G string. And you can see that as I move the slider over, and now it's the G note, you can see the change in both of the top left, top right graphs. And you can do that for any number of the strings. If you look at the violin image, the string itself is now vibrating different than when it was at the G note or the A note. And then you've got something even more interesting here on the bottom right. It's called the harmonic number. Now notice when I move this to 2 or to 3 or 4, look at the violin image itself. That string tension and that wave is starting to move in all different levels and frequencies. And then when I let go of that mouse click and I leave it at 8, for instance, the graphs then redraw itself. And it's not just something static, it's not something boring, it's not just the science behind it, but it's taking all these different elements of the visual appeal, the science, the ability to interact. Now, this is the second component, and I'll quickly review. The first component's the narrative, the thought-provoking question or questions posed. The second component of our simulation is the science, the interactive pieces. And now we can get into the third component, which are the different questions that we might be wanting to think about as a learner. We might want to be thinking about, well, how does sound frequency behave in other types of settings? And then we bring them into something that, again, continues to, you know, I think, provoke different thoughts and questions among the learner. Now, we can go back to our more examples, and we can click through different examples. So we can say, how is the body of the violin important? And these are contextual things that we want to provide because we want to extend and further enrich that student as they're learning. And that's essentially the simulation. Now, again, I want to emphasize this is a beta, but this is something that we were just so excited about here at CK12. We wanted to release it, wanted to get it into the hands of the teachers, of the students, of any learner to begin using. You know, if they've got a projector, they can hook up their laptop and they're in their classroom. I've already heard from a teacher saying, you know, I'm happy to show this to my classroom because now I can kind of manipulate things and use your real world example and visually show them as well as talk about in the classroom to the students. And that's a real powerful message, being able to do that. So we've just briefly talked about the simulations. Now using our chat feature, you know, how would you use the CK12 simulations? Don already has mentioned, you know, examples of waves, and absolutely. And that's just one example, Don, that I showed. You know, there's a variety of physics-related simulations. And that's great. Yeah, absolutely. You know, how will that math get incorporated? How will that science get overlaid? And those are all things that we thoughtfully considered. So definitely, Don, you know, it's something that, you know, we're thinking about. And I'm so glad you expressed this because, you know, students have those questions. Now you have a tool, these simulations, to hopefully combine those kind of questions, that curiosity, and help reinforce some of the things going on in the classroom or even out of the classroom. Definitely, Trey, you know, sine and frequency relative to sound wave and FM radio and frequency on graph. And that really brings me into sort of, I want to share another teacher conversation I had just yesterday, which is, you know, this gives them, or the teacher said, you know, your simulations are going to give me abilities to not just use your simulations alone, but to really incorporate things that they've curated as a teacher. Awesome. Yeah, absolutely. You know, good teachers borrow, and I think great teachers steal outright. So steal away, Trey. You know, take everything that our site has to offer. You know, we have not only the simulations, but all different modalities. And so, you know, if it's anybody's first time peeking into CK12, bit of background about us. We began back in 2006/2007. It really was the vision of our founder to, you know, make educational content of a high quality, a high grade, freely available across the globe, and always free. And that's been our goal, and that continues to be our goal and what drives us. So as we move through, I'm going to go ahead and now just point out a couple of interesting things that we've done to update our site during the summer before the school year began. And the first thing is going to be our standards browser. And so what we've done is at the top of our page, we have a standards button. By clicking one of the two, you'll be taken to a screen that shows you the Common Core math standards. And on the left-hand side, you've got a toolbar that allows you to select the different levels. And as a teacher, you might select, well, I'm teaching 7th grade. You can click on grade 7, and the screen that refreshes will portray all the different related Common Core math standards. At the very top, you can go ahead and click on Learn More. And what this will do is take you, export you out to the Common Core Standards website. But let's go back to our page here. And now you're seeing that for that standard, that Common Core math standard, we've gone ahead and portrayed all the different CK12 concepts. And to the student, there you've got a number of different concepts at the ready to use. And as well, when you look at this screen here, not only do you have those concepts, but within you have a number of different modalities, and these are essentially ways of learning this particular concept. So that's something that we've added and made an update over the summer, and we have heard from our community nothing but positive remarks saying that now it's that much easier to implement this in the classroom. And something that we've built out over the course of the summer is we've really enhanced our help resources. But we also have something new we've introduced called CK12 implementation models. For example, if I click on this first one, using CK12's Flexbook as a textbook supplement or replacement, the minute that you click this thumbnail, it'll take you to our YouTube channel. And this is where we've built these really sort of digestible, small, usually under a minute long videos. So I'm going to back out and just point out one last thing about these implementation models is that we also have these steps, these videos in text format. So if you want to know how to register step by step without having to watch a video and pause at the right second or rewind it, we've got it as well in text form. And so we're hoping that we've satisfied all the different people interested about CK12 wanting to know how to begin and making that extremely easy for you. Okay, so I'm going to move on to just one last thing about CK12 I want to show everyone, and that's really some of the new filtering options that we've created within our platform. And I think we've got a wonderful way, and what I want to do now is show you that. You know, as I scroll down, let me just go ahead and type in waves as a keyword, and it's going to go ahead and search for all this great content within our library. And this is going to encompass content, not only stuff we've created, but anything that people have published and contributed to CK12 for the general population to benefit and use as well. But you'll notice we've added these new filters on our left of the screen. Everything from grade level to subjects to categories, as well as content. Again, I just mentioned that we've got all this great content that over a body of 7 years we've built and delivered and refined and continue to put out there. So we've just made that searching much better. So you might decide, hey, I want to find out, you know, search for waves. I want to see all the different types of readings that are available around waves. I want to maybe push this out there to my students, maybe share this resource. And you can go ahead and click on it and then share that resource to the group. Thank you, everybody, and have a great, great evening.